Welcome to Rahul's classroom. Today we are planning to discuss CBSE Grade 12 Accountancy, first chapter, non-profit making organizations, basics 3. In the last videos, we were explaining the final accounts of non-profit making organization. It consists of three, we were explained, like receipt payment account, income and expenditure account, and finally balance sheet. These are the final accounts of non-profit making organizations. Today we are explaining the differences between receipt and payment account and income and expenditure account. In the last video, we properly explained what is receipt and payment account and what is income and the expenditure account. Now we are explaining the basic differences between these two. You understood by the students? So please listen now. So we are discussing the differences now. First of all, the purpose. The purpose of receipt and payment account is that to determine the cash balance at the end. But in case of income and expenditure account, it is prepared for the purpose of finding the deficit or surplus. Then second point is so the nature of the accounts we are preparing, say the receipt and payment account and the income and expenditure account. Basically, receipt and payment account is a summary of cash transactions. It's a summary of cash transactions, and therefore we can say it's a real account. It's a real account because cash is an asset, and again all assets are come under the category of real account. So we can say receipt and payment account is a real account. But income and expenditure account, that is prepared for the purpose of finding the surplus or deficit by comparing incomes and the expenses. All incomes and expenses are come under the category or division of nominal account. You understand it now? So income and expenditure account is a nominal account. Next difference, recording of the items into these two accounts. So here the receipt and payment account, in case of receipt and payment account, we are recording all receipts on the debit side, all receipts on the debit side and all payments on the credit side. But why in case of the income and expenditure account, we are following a reverse pattern? That means all receipts are shown on the credit side and all payments are shown on the debit side. Then the fourth difference, the balance. That is how to start these accounts. Arshina, please listen up here. Arshina, please. Then okay. So please, here the balance is now. Then the receipt and payment account begins with opening balance of cash and ends with the closing balance of cash. But in case of income and expenditure account, it has no opening balance. Income and expenditure, it has no opening balance. But in case of receipt and payment account, it is begins with an opening balance of cash. Okay. Next difference, the contents now. Okay, it contains all, that means the receipt and payment account contain all transactions. All transactions means the total receipts and payments, what they paid and what they received during that year. And this receipt may be either for the present year or the previous year or for an upcoming year. But in case of income and expenditure account, it records only the transactions which are related to the current year. That means, in case of income and expenditure, we are not recording the items which are related to the previous year or items which are related to the next year. It excludes all such transactions. But in case of receipt and payment account, it records all transactions. That means all transactions means what they received and what they paid. And the payment or receipts may be either for this year or for the previous year or for the next year. We are not considering such demarcation here. Okay, next difference, the capital and revenue items. In receipt and payment account, it records both. Both means it records both the revenue receipts or revenue payments, again capital receipts and capital payments. But in case of income and expenditure account, it records only the revenue items, that means revenue payments and the revenue incomes. You understood my students? So please listen, Mr. Amin. Please listen here. Amin, please tell. Okay, so now again, next difference, the accounting policy. Receipt and payment account is purely following the cash based accounting system. That means in receipt and payment account, it records only the cash transactions, what they received and what they paid. But in case of the income and expenditure account, it records or it follows an accrual basis. That means it includes the amount to be received, the amount and amount to be paid. Okay, next, last difference, the items. In case of receipt and payment account, it records only the cash transactions. That means we can't see any non-cash transactions into the receipt and the payment account. It exclusively for recording the cash transactions. Okay, but in case of income and expenditure account, it records both. Both means both cash transactions and the non-cash transactions. Say for example, we are recording depreciation in income and expenditure account, but it has no place into where? Into the receipt and the payment account. So these are the differences between receipt and payment account and income and expenditure account. Okay, so once again we are repeating the topics or the items of difference. Say number one, the purpose. It is prepared for the purpose of finding closing cash balance, but the income and expenditure account is prepared for finding the deficit or surplus. Next one, the nature. The receipt and payment account is a real account, but the other one, that means the income and expenditure account, is a nominal account. Third difference, recording style. Receipts and receipts are shown on the debit side of the receipt and payment account, but the payments are shown on the credit side. But in case of income and expenditure account, they are following a reverse pattern. Next one, the balances. Then here, the receipt and payment account begins with an opening balance of cash and ending with a closing balance of cash. But in case of income and expenditure account, there is no opening balance and closing balance. Next one, capital and revenue item. Receipt and payment account record both the revenue items and the capital items. But in case of income and expenditure account, it records only the revenue payments and revenue receipts. Next difference, contains. It contains, that means receipt and payment account contain all transactions, but the income and expenditure account will absorb only the current year's transactions. Okay, next one, accounting policy. The receipt and payment account records the cash transactions only or cash basis, or they are following a cash basis accounting system. But income and expenditure account, that follows an accrual based system. And finally, items, Then again, in receipt and payment account, we can see only the cash transactions, but in case of income and expenditure account, it absorbs both the cash and the non-cash transactions. Okay. Today we are winding the class, and we will meet with a new video. Okay. Thank you.